Urubata.
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 Eh.
There are fewer than 10 people in the world who can speak the Yakunte language. Tiridu Sakui is one of them. He doesn't know exactly how old he is, but when we met him before the global pandemic, all of the remaining speakers were over 70. It's the language of the Yaku, an ethnic group of about 4,000 people. Most now speak other languages. They live in the hills of central Kenya, near the town of Doldol. This nearby building used to be a center for Yaku culture and language. It was built about 20 years ago with charitable donations. People used to sit around a fire here and sing songs. But about 7 years ago, it was abandoned during a conflict between Samburu and Maasai, neighboring ethnic groups, both more populous and both with their own language still in use. And so the cultural artifacts and books that were kept inside were taken away and put in storage, and the gatherings stopped. The Yaku people used to be hunter-gatherers living in a nearby forest. Teridu now herds livestock instead. The Maasai, a larger ethnic group of herders, moved into the area about 100 years ago.
These people realized if we embrace Maasai, we are able to even transact easily with these people. We can own cattle, and cattle economy came with the language.
The rest of Teridu's family don't know how to speak Yaku. They speak the Maasai language, Ma, at home. His daughter, Wanjiru, speaks Swahili with her friends.
I would like Wanjiru to speak Yaku at school. She can't learn it at home because I don't know it. If she learned it in school, then she can teach us.
And I want all of us.
But at Wanjiru's school,
so that we can see,
it's mostly English. It's been the language of education and business in Kenya ever since British colonization. And it was white British settlers who displaced the Maasai into the Yaku's homelands. This traditional Yaku song is about living in caves and hunting in the forest. It's a way of life that's long gone. And soon, the language and the culture and identity that come with it will be gone too. Malcolm Webb, Al Jazeera, Doldol, Kenya.